Hello there, amazing and wonderful geeky people of YouTube. So, this is kind of something new I want to try and do here, and that's basically make you people aware of shady or not so kosher or problematic distributions, developers in the Linux community, because it's really, really big. There's a lot of people that are trying to basically get money out of you for nothing, or trying to scam or what you will call it, or lure you into giving them money by using other people's work, stealing code, and, you know, reusing assets. There's a lot of things going. I'm not saying that in this particular, like we're looking at the Linspire, a free spire today, I'm not saying that they're doing that, but what I want to do now is, this is one of my pet peeves, these kind of things where people are taking other people's work and reselling it. Because it is doable in the Linux community, because everything is open source and blah blah blah, and it's, you can see the source code, you can distribute it freely and all that, and you can actually ask money for it. So a lot of shady people, they are like, I put a badge on it that say something, and then I will sell it to you, where it's really just either Ubuntu, Debian, or something like that. I'm not going after the person when I'm doing these kind of things. I'm going after their work. The dude or the dudes working on this distribution here could be the nicest and most amazing people in the world. It's their work I'm criticizing. It's not them. So try and remember that when you're watching this. And like I said, I think this will be a series I want to do. I don't know what to call it. If you guys have any ideas, the title for this video will just be like a pilot thing, if you can call it like that. I have this idea of calling it Shady Distros or something like that. I don't know, you guys are better at English and all that than I am. So if you have any idea of what you can call this series, where I look at a distribution or a development team that I think is a little bit shady, they're not, you know, up to standards, or they, you know, you have some reservations about them, give me an idea. But I've been looking at Linspire Free. I'm using FreeSpire right now because I refuse to give this guy money for the reasons I will go into in a bit. This will not be me going into the distributions, looking at the kernel and looking at how stable it is and all that. I'm just basically telling you guys what to look out for when you're on their websites and all that, and you can take these experience with you to other websites or other distribution makers and see if they're doing some of the same thing, overhyped marketing and basically lying to you, as this dude is doing or this company here is doing. You can spot shady developers, you can spot shady distros, you can spot shady companies, you know, companies that may bend the truth or may try to, you know, get some money out of you without giving you much in return, to be honest. So it will be focused mostly on their website, on information. I will look a little bit of the distro. I think I actually have a review of FreeSpire on my channel. If we look at just like the source software sources or repositories, I like to do that to see where distributions are taking programs from, you know, software from. And if it's a distribution, you know, what I call a distribution, they have their own repositories in there. They are doing their own thing, you know, they are repackaging or optimizing packages for themselves, or they are having their own repositories to bring software that may not be available native under Linux or Ubuntu or Arch or something like that. They are making the distribution their own. They are not just taking repositories and then installing programs for you that they like to use and theme it up. And as you can see here, they are using Launchpad, they are using Yawnu. Ubuntu is a boot repair tool that I haven't heard about. We have, if my scrolling window here actually will work. It's the US repositories for Ubuntu. It's basically just Ubuntu, and it's based on 10.18.04, as you can see here, 0.10. So it do have the hardware enable stack kernel in it, like the 5. If you can see here, the 5.0.2. There's updates. I haven't installed the update, so the kernel may be updated a little bit, but it's the long-term release. Also, I was looking at snaps here, because we will get into that in a bit, to see if there were any snaps installed, and they're using Chromium as their default browser. So, this is FreeSpire I have installed, but I will talk about Linspire, because FreeSpire is basically their free version of Linspire. you're getting some extra software in Linspire, but you're not getting so much, and then you have to pay. You have to pay for Linspire and self-support. This is $39. I had to pay in Denmark with the taxes and everything. I had to pay, I think it was 39 or something like that, or 30 something bucks, because I was debating on buying it. And you are getting, well, you can actually see here the kernel that they say here, the kernel is already newer here, but that's because, you know, you have to update it. KDE 5.12, that's a really, really old KDE version. So if you go in here to say about, yeah, it's 5.12. I think Kubuntu is 5.16 or 15 or something like that. Debian is 5.14, and Debian tends to have older software. And you can actually get 5.17 in here. I can install Kubuntu's PPAs, development PPAs, and get 5.17. At least do that. But anyway, you get ICE, you get Chrome, you get Color Paint. This is basically a KDE program. I don't know if that's in here. Is that in here? Yeah, it's in here. That's also in here in FreeSpy. You get OnlyOff, Amarok, KPatience, DreamShares, VLC, Boot Repair, that's also in here. Firewall configuration, that's always also in here. PowerShell. And this is what you get in the Linspire version. So if so far, the only extra thing you get if you're buying Linspire or FreeSpire is proprietary drivers and PowerShell. And I think you can actually install PowerShell. In here, and we will give them. Okay, we need to do classic. Okay, so now it's installing. I need to do the classic. I couldn't remember where to put it in the command line. And he or they, the developer here, makes a really big deal of this. Also, you get OnlyOff here, which you can also install here. If I install NVIDIA drivers and all that shit, and install PowerShell, and I theme this up to be a Linspire, I would have a Linspire version. And they want 30 or 29 or 39, depending where you is in the world, basically cash for that. And that's without support. If you want them to support, you can get a 12-month license for $60. Two license, three license, studio, blah, 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 corporate license. That's actually really, really, really expensive. But basically, hear me out, basically a Kubuntu LTS install. This is Kubuntu LTS. This is what you're getting. That's themed and nothing else. They have installed PowerShells and some extra tools. That's it. And they expect you to buy to pay them $30 for that. If you want a Linspire version, I will package this up for you for $10. Like, to be honest, if he asked $10 for Linspire, I think I would pay $10 for Linspire. Because it's like an hour work. You know, $10 an hour, that's a good fucking amount of money, if you ask me. PowerShell is installed, right? I don't know if it's aggregated here in the menu yet. No, it is. It is. But yeah, I could find the themes for Linspire and whatnot and figure out what programs they have installed and give you all the multimedia codecs and all that within 30 minutes or something like that, maybe an hour. And that's $10 with no support. I do get that if you want support, yeah, why not? That's actually awesome that they are supporting. But what I think this company should be, they should be a support company instead of selling a distribution. They should be like, here, download Kubuntu or have Kubuntu their own ISO for free with everything, like basically, instead of calling it give Linspire away for free, for fuck's sake, you know. And then be like, you can get it for free with no support, or pay us like $5 to $10, or you pay what you want, like the elementary way. And then it can be like, but we are focusing on supporting you. So if you want support, this is what our goal is. This is what we want to do. Because we don't have a lot of companies giving like desktop support and all that. So that should be their goal. It should not be to try and resell Linspire. And the way that they are doing it is also like, they are, oh, it's so and all over again, overhyped and all that shit. And these are some things that I will mention some things here, read some things up from their website, and this will be a long video also, so get some coffee. But these things, when you see these things mentioned in the website or with the distribution company and stuff like that, you should be worried. Here there was a story about it was sending information to Microsoft, and that's because it's using PowerShell and Skype and all that. Well, who are our customers for Linspire? Who uses Linspire? Linspire is used in many different environments and by a diverse group of individuals. No problem with that. And home office and all kind of enterprise level customers. Here, I want examples. Like IBM is using it in this scenario. Anyone that gives out that it's used, or these companies are using our, or these branches of or companies is using our product, they always cite what they are used for and what companies they are. They're not just saying, well, it's used. No, they give you, basically, they give you information. They are like, IBM is using it in their office for HR, or Bob's cake maker is using it for his wife, you know. They always give you, like, these companies are using it, and this is the branches of the company. It's also used by educational facilities. What kind of educational facilities? The homeschool, the public education facilities of Ohio or something like that. We need those information. Law enforcement agencies, which LAPD, New York PD, you know, you need to cite that shit. And if they don't do that, that's because they are bending the truth a little bit. It could be that all these educational facilities, law enforcement agencies, are using Ubuntu. And this is basically Ubuntu. So they are kind of like, well, Ubuntu, Linspire is kind of the same, so we can say it's also in the military, but branches of the military. Marines, Army, Navy, citation, scientists. What scientists are you associated with? Creative professionals. Is there any YouTubers out there using it? Is there any, you know, graphical artist out there using it? Put that down below. Does removing application make the system less attractive to end users? Meh, that's kind of okay. How did you choose the software? That's also just, you know. Is the main distro using the only one being updated? No. Are the enterprise release also being updated? Like, I don't know why they put that in there. And another thing. If you want to be a professional company, they want to attract professional users and big corporations, don't have your main website being a blog. This is a blog site. This is a blog site, my friends. Yeah. Blogger. If I was like a Fortune 100, 500, whatever company, and I wanted to, you know, go and look at a site and stuff like that, and I see this plastered with advertisement, looking really unprofessional made, and it's a blog, I would be like, yeah, they don't take this serious. At least they have like a domain name, but yeah, they don't take this seriously. They don't. Just for the sake of argument. Is it FarenOS? Can I spell that right? If you go into FarenOS, this is made in a website builder site, Weebly. A lot of companies are using Weebly. Let's compare these two. This is FarenOS's website, made by one guy, a really, really young kid. And this is like a official corporation with more than one distribution that they are selling to offices, law enforcement, governments, and blah, 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 blah. Does this smell a little bit like, maybe not. This looks way more professional than this thrown together thing that you can do in an hour when you're trying to get your kids to sleep. Just think about this. Smells a little bit like, okay, they're just out to get money out of people. Let's get further into it, because it gets really, really, really interesting. Let's close this one down. About, you can have here a Linspire product brochure, a CE, an educational licensing here with 4-year extended warranty. It's basically just the Ubuntu support. Linspire desktop features. You get a web browser. Wow, which one? which web browser do you get? You get LibreOffice, email client. What LibreOffice client do? Music. What kind of music do I get? Do I get the latest Maroon 5 album? Or you see, all this just smells like a video player. Ooh, What kind of video player? Dropbox. Yeah, you can get that in any distributions. GIMP. Font Manager. That's built into almost any desktop environment. Inkscape. NitroShare. Synergy. Built-in antivirus. Integrated virtual machine software. Vine. .NET Core support. All of this is what Kubuntu have, basically, or you can get it with no problem at all. They have here the software, the click and run. This was really, really big back in the day when Linspire, like the real Linspire, was out there. They had like a click and run software site where you basically just, okay, I want to install LibreOffice. You click the link and it installed you forward. It was amazing. But with the software thing we have here, or stores, we have Discovery here in KDE. You see here, like, it's not that needed anymore, but it's basically just a website version of either GNOME software or Discovery or like that, or Discover or something like that. Here it's capability with Ubuntu and Red Hat Enterprise Linux application. So can I install RPM packages on this system? Can I install RPM pack, or do they mean if you compile program from source? You see, there's a lot of red flags here. If people, or let's say if companies that you want to do business with, if they are not to the point, clear with their information, you should be really, 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 oh, here, they say a little bit about, I need to read this, I forgot that. But if they are vague with their information and all that, you should not do business with them. Because it means that it's not that close, it's not that good. Companies that tells you, like, let's say open SUSE, let's go in here. I think they have something called partners or something like that. They're sponsored by, you know, which one is sponsored them. You can go in and see, or if we just take SUSE, they're actually telling you, and these are the guys that they want to compete with. This company here wants to compete with this company here, or Red Hat, or Ubuntu. Let's see, partners. Community, support services, product and solutions. Here, you can see here, you can read about who's using them. Blogs, popular topics. Here, customer success stories. I need to save this one because I will get into that in a bit with this system here. You can see here, they have T-system and what they are used for and all that shit. And this company wants to compete with this. Again, it smells like a cash grab, if you ask me. But anyway, with Linspire, you can host an entire line of legacy applications, blah, 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 blah. Linspire OS is the only Debian and Ubuntu-based system that is certified by Oracle and IBM to host and deploy their respectively cloud technologies. I think Ubuntu also is, to be honest, and a lot of other distributions. Linspire is deployed by 4 out of 5 U.S. military branches and is in use by the NOAA and the National Weather Service. Yeah, but can you prove it? Like, prove it like they're doing over here. I think, to be honest, I think this is Ubuntu, to be honest. I think that's Ubuntu. Linspire is also used by many local law enforcement agencies, as well as deployed in over 100 school systems in 50 states. States, schools, and what kind of system they are using. Again, like they are doing here. Linspire shipped pre-installed on our system for maximum performances. I have not seen anywhere where I can buy a computer with Linspire pre-installed on their website. This is how you do it. This is how you create your... Oh, this is actually in Denmark. Computer service in Denmark. Hey! I didn't notice that. Intelligence. Well, Danish people and intelligence don't really go well together. But anyway, this is how you do it. And this is how most big, or not well big, but companies that take it seriously, how they do it. They have sites like this where you can go in here and you can see where they have been, where the system has been used. Again, if people are vague, if they don't go in and give you these kind of details when they are citing stuff like this, means that it's not 100% true. Again, you know, like, you go, if you're going to buy a car or a house, And they're like, ooh, it has this and this and this. Oh, it has like a new kitchen and shit like that. And you ask them, oh, how old is the kitchen? And they start to talk, you know, around it. And who installed the kitchen? Blah, 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 blah. Oh, you should see the balcony, you know. If they don't want to talk about it, means that it's, yeah, it may be new, but it could be their uncle that know nothing about setting kitchen up, that are putting a new kitchen. And the new, quote-unquote, new kitchen was his old kitchen that they put in there. But for the house, it's new because the house, the kitchen is older than the house, so it's technically a new kitchen. You know, if they don't want to talk about the details, you should be like, yeah, I don't want to spend money, give you money. You get my drift here? This is really, really shady when you read all of this. Let's look at the brochures here. Product overview. It's basically just what you read about on the website. It's basically taken right out of the website. Pricing. The CE version, Cloud Edition. Take that away. There's nothing there really. This is their Cloud Edition. Again, it's, I think this is actually built not on Ubuntu server, but I think they're just taking Ubuntu and stripping it down and then putting some cloud information into it. All of these here are stock standard programs you can get on almost any distribution. Linspire server, I think this is just Ubuntu server. Oh, I totally forgot it. Let's see up here. It actually is saying FreeSpire. The version before this, I think it was, when it booted up, it had the Ubuntu boot screen. Like, it's so unprofessional. Linspire Insider program. This makes no sense whatsoever. The Linspire Insider program is a program for developers and users who want to be involved in Linspire and contribute to code and to the operating system. And then they offer different levels, like a fucking really, really expensive level. Why don't they just have like a submit page, or, you know, like Ubuntu have launch pads? You know, Ubuntu don't even do this, man. And this is basically Ubuntu with KDE on it. It just smells, man. This company is trying to sell you Ubuntu, basically, and then taking all the money for themselves. The web store, what are they selling here? It's a little bit about refunds. Here, testimonies, this is the one that fucking... This one here makes me want to take my genitalia and cut them off and throw them out to the dogs and start to be named Josephine or something like that, because this is just... Yeah. Testimonies. They have like here, PC, blah, 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 is our very quick and was quick and efficient, blah, blah, blah. Here's a testimony. There's no name, there's no company name, so this means nothing. Again, shady. They could have typed it in themselves, because we have no way to verify it. Again, you can verify it here. It could be the developers themselves that have said this here. The server that we ordered right before schedule and was seriously just a drop in our infrastructure. We were very surprised with the ease of use of the software component. This is a model of what other Linux distributions aspire to be, or aspire to. Again, what company is this? A name for a guy or anything that again, like this, that verify that this is true. Because again, you could have put this in yourself here. Coming from Red Hat Enterprise Linux, we were very curious about dealing with a smaller company, but we found blah 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 to be very responsive to our needs and was very helpful in getting our custom Red Hat Linux apps ported and working on the Inspire servers and Inspire desktop. Extremely satisfied. Company name. And if the guys here, if this is a real guy and say, well, I don't want my name out there and I don't want my company out there, don't put it on your website. Another one. Our studio uses Macs and old CTR. I love STI computers. And they, again, same thing. There's no name, there's no company name, nothing like that here. Again, the same. At least Sovereign is doing that, TechRadar, PC World. If you go on to Ubuntu, I think they have it. All other distributions out there that want money from you, they have credible sources that's cited this in. And here, this is also why I hate Sovereign. Linspire is the world's easiest to use operating system. Bullshit, that's Macintosh and Windows, because most people know how to use Macintosh and Windows. That's just how it is. It's no debate. Based on our past work, we are the industry leading in desktop No, you're not. Ubuntu is the industry leading Linux desktop operating system and development. It's the biggest, it's the most installed, therefore they are the leading guys. Many companies and government agencies use our desktop Linux products, and many resource facilities such as HPC, sounds like a sexual transmitted disease, products, and many educational facilities, blah 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 blah. Again, citation, we need to know who these guys are. You need to back this up with facts. If you can't, if you cannot fact check what people are saying to you, when they want to sell you a distribution, or they want you to use a distribution and stuff like that, especially if they didn't want money for this, I would have no problem with it. No problem whatsoever. This is just the fact that they want money for something that it's not true, basically. They give you a false sense of security, of some really, really semi-accurate information, and then you'll be like, wow, whoa, yay. And also, if they were the leading distribution or Linux, the industry leaders in desktop operating system and all that, don't you think they have money to buy a fucking website? Or have some web developer develop a website for them? Again. Baron OS. A kid from the States that still have puberty running all over his face. I don't know how old he is, but I'm just saying that. Have a more professional website, even though it's on a website builder, but it's still more professional than the industry leader in Linux desktop and operating system development. And a guy from the States that eats McDonald's 5 times a week has a better website. This smells like bullshit. Let's go into it again. Available commercial software. All of this you can get via flat packs, app images, PPAs, Humble Indie Bundle, Steam. What? Steam. Do they want you to buy Steam from them? Or what? As they are tested. This list is incomplete as we are adding more supported. Oh, I think this is like commercial supported software. But still. And then again, bad ads all over the place. Again here. Fucking bad, man. Like I said, so shady. So shady. Estic compared these guys here to like a used car salesman. I do really believe that used car salesmen have more morals and are better at their job than they are here. This is like the educational, so we don't want to look in. It's basically the same shit. FAQ, let's see if we can find some more shady shit here. Why is it a commercial? What hardware does it? CAD programs, VirtualBox. What are the different from Linspire Inc? This was the original owners of Linspire. Yeah, what's the difference between Linspire and FreeSpire? Linspire is a commercial product, yeah. The product contains proprietary software and code is for commercial as well as more facilities for machine emulation, security and development, and you get a 12-month support subscription. Business, government, education facilities and commercial customers can get our features such as on-site support, blah blah blah. FreeSpire is a fast distribution which contains no proprietary codecs, so you can basically install everything. You can install everything that Linspire has, and then FreeSpire becomes Linspire. Without paying them. Because what they are doing is they are taking away software they don't like, putting in software they like, installing snaps or flat packs or whatever they're doing that they like, and that's basically it. We will be focusing on working with Canonical and Canonical's core Ubuntu product. At least they are recognizing that they are based on Ubuntu here. We will make improvement on the base and fork from it when we feel it's necessary. I have seen no evidence of this whatsoever because they have not done anything. They may have submitted some code to Launchpad and it's been put into Ubuntu, fair enough. But like I said, they are not using their own PPAs. They have not forked anything yet. This is just bullshit. They're just blowing hot air up your butthole. Linspire and FreeSpire will not be just remastered Ubuntu spins. This is exactly what they are. Linspire and FreeSpire will not be... Does this even make sense? Linspire and FreeSpire will not be just remastered. Is my English bad or is this not proper English? Even my English is bad, but I have a problem with this. Linspire and FreeSpire will not be I think there should be an A here, so I don't know. Remastered Ubuntu spin, but that's what it is. Like I said, I have seen no evidence of them putting in their own code or anything like that other than theming. However, Ubuntu is the recognized community desktop leader. You just said you were the leader. Who is the leader? Who do you follow? And there are hundreds of thousands of app, blah, 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 blah. New blogs and we will be targeting the new Inspire towards the markets where we are undisputed leaders, HPC, education, and the enterprise. Go fuck yourself. Okay, for education, I know for a fact that Ubuntu is leading in the education space. The enterprise and specialized desktop services, that's Ubuntu, Red Hat, I think you will go Red Hat if you take them like the biggest, Red Hat, Ubuntu, SUSE, and then maybe some other distributions. They are the leaders in those. You're not undisputed. I don't know what HPC is. Like I say, it sounds like a sexual transmitted disease, but I could be wrong. This is the biggest bullshit I've seen ever. Again, reading this, if I was a company, if I had to invest in this company here, in PC, whatever it's called, and I read stuff like this, I'll be like, yeah, they should not get my business. Our release is based on the KDE desktop, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Oh, it's panel layout and graphics will not change. Well, it is changed. You changed the color scheme. You changed the icon up here. So that's, it's just a small little criticism. But, it is changed. You know, also the layout by default, this panel is down here. I know it is for a fact on Linspire, but the Linspire desktop is also themed with a little L up here. So there's custom graphics on it. And I think there's also a custom icon theme. What happens to Black Lab Linux, which is a distribution I never installed because I already back then find it shady. And here it says that it will be separately developed alongside Linspire. And if you read this, it makes it sounds like it's this company is a really, really big group of people. And to be honest, I think they are like 10 people employed in total or something like that. Thereabouts, maybe. I did put a number on it, but it's just me speculating because I think I read it somewhere. And they say they will have an XFCE XFCE for legacy hardware. And the fact is that KDE use less resources than XFCE out of the box, so yeah, maybe. Yeah, this just smells of like bullshit all over the place. Support. Here you can. I can't look at the website, man. This is the forum. I don't like the coloring of it, but that's, well, it's a forum. This has been me tearing apart their websites and how what they're saying to people and their business practices and whatnot. This is a prime example of what you have to look for or you have to research before you go and spend money for people, give people money. Let's say you're one of these people that wants to support a developer out there with money. You want to pay them. And you see these kind of guys here. And you read all of this, when you read their website, and you should, if you want to spend money, if you're a company, a person, or whatever, if you don't already know and trust the developers and all that, you need to research them. What are people saying about them? And what I hear from other Linux users is kind of the same thing what I'm talking about, that all in all, Linspire and FreeSpire is just a respin of Ubuntu. There's nothing excited about it. You could install Kubuntu and make it to be FreeSpire or Linspire with no effort whatsoever. With no effort whatsoever. And if some of you guys say, oh, you cannot do it and all that, I will make a fucking video where I do it. I will figure out what programs is installed on Linspire and I will make a Linspire distribution and put the ISO up for you. There may be some themings that I can't get if they're using their own like icons and all that shit. But like I said, you need to research them, and you need to figure out if they're worth your money, because money don't, like, if you're a fucking oil shike or something like that, yeah, your money is just falling down on the sky. But for me, this is a lot of money to spend on just a hobby, you know, like, this is around the same money that I pay for a gym membership for a month. It's the same kind of money I spend on junk food a month, maybe a little bit more on junk food. Maybe a little bit more, but you know, this what most people will spend on junk food for like 2 weeks or a month or something like that. It could be like a cinema, you're out to the cinemas or something like that. You know what I'm saying here? You have to look at it that way. And are these guys are they worthy enough for that money, for that time? Money is time. That's basically how money is. Like, money is time. You know. It takes time to get money, you work to get money, which is time, and you pay people money for their time to make a distribution, or for their time to make a video, for their time to make a movie, for their time to make your popcorns. You're basically paying time, like really, like some, if you're a little bit looking at it from a philosophical kind of way, I think you would call it, you know. It is basically just a currency put on time. And are they worthy of that time? Are they worthy of $30 or something like that? They could have an amazing support team. This is something I would love to see if other people have any experience with their support, and see what they are saying about. Because I have a suspicion that if they cannot put up a normal website, they cannot cite credible sources for their information, And everything seems to be just hacked together in an afternoon, and their distribution seems to be the same. How good can their support be? If you want to go in to a CEO, or you want to go in and you want to pitch like an idea or a business idea, something like that, you don't go in and pitch it in Hawaii shirts and have not showered in 4 days and you just came out of the fucking bar with your cargo pants on. You put on a suit, you try to look presentable, you will look nice, smell nice, you know, give a good impression, because these guys are potentially going to give you money. So you want to put your best foot forward. They are not doing that right here. Again, that's why they are shady. That's why it seems not to be what it again, you know, what it seems to be. What I think this is a company that takes Ubuntu and reskin it. They take the cat, they take off the skin, they put a leopard skin on it or something nice, and they go tell people, here, buy our special leopard or something, you know, our special tiger. And basically what this is just Kubuntu. This is Kubuntu with a pretty face on it, or if you can even say it like that. Even the fucking install on this, when I installed this system, it had the Kubuntu logo on it. There are so many places here where you can go in and you can find small little things, you know, where like you want people to pay money for stuff like that, and you don't remove the Kubuntu logo, and like I said, it's just a half-assed job. And you cannot have a professional company and be professional if it's not a professional product you sell. Like I said, I cannot talk about the support, but if they, again, this is how people see it. If their support is anything like their operating systems that they're making, their distribution, or the way that they conduct themselves on their websites, or how their websites look, it may not be the best support out there. I'm just saying, you may get better support for less money, or maybe a little bit more for other places. And by them calling themselves industry leaders in blah 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 desktop environment and all that, and then they later say, oh, Ubuntu is the industry leader, but we are the industry leader in education and enterprise, which is the biggest BS you can get your head around, or you can tell people, because that's, like I said, Ubuntu, Red Hat, SUSE, you know, stuff like that. They are the industry leaders in enterprise and educational space because they're the most installed. What I think this, like I said, these guys are doing here, again, like Esten said, they are taking a used car and trying to sell it as a brand new, unique car. They're taking a distribution and trying to sell it as their own original work, as something special, as something that you will not get anywhere else, where in fact it's not. You can get this anywhere else. You can make it yourself with ease. Like, I could understand if they put so much effort into it that if I had to respin or make Kubuntu look like this and function like Linspy or FreeSpy, it would take me a day or two. Yeah, fuck it, I will give them $30. But if I can do this in like an afternoon when I'm bored and watching you know, the adult sites on the internet, well, how much value are you giving to the world? Nothing. You're basically just trying to get money out of people for minimum effort. And that's what scammers do. That's what shady people do. They are not saying here that they are heavily based on Ubuntu, Kubuntu, and they have no original software in here. They may have in the future. They may have in the future. But as it looks right now, this is not worth any money whatsoever. Again, $5-$10 or what, or the way that Elementary do it, pay what you want. I would have given them a couple of bucks. If this was $5, I would buy Linspire just to check it out. And I don't, to be honest, the last 5 months, every time the paycheck comes in, I've been like, add to cart, and then I was like, it's $30. I make a video. I don't make $30 out of video. I don't make any money out of videos. It's basically just $30 out of the window for me, and I'd rather have a pizza or a night out or, you know, have fun with a friend, have a beer, than giving them those kind of money. Have it been $5 for self-support, no problem whatsoever. And I think the 12 months should be $30, to be honest. I would be like, well, it's $5. I install it once and I throw it out, whatever, you know. But I feel that you guys need to know this. You need to be aware of these kind of guys, because these guys here are the guys that makes everyone else in think badly about the Linux community. And I hear it a lot also, and it's something people, a lot of people don't talk about, is that there are a lot of these kind of guys here, and a lot of new people to Linux, they get trapped by these kind of guys here, and then they get like a bad taste in their mouth. You know, they got burned, they feel they got scammed, they didn't get what they pay for, so they think everyone else is like that. If you guys have other developers, distributions that you think is a little bit shady or stuff like that, I would love to look at them, because I kind of like to do this shit. Because like I said, I think we need to tell people about these kind of guys so they don't get trapped into them. And again, if you have any idea to what we should call these kind of thing videos here, let me know down below. But I'll see you all later. Bye bye.